verses 13 through 25.
It was dawn on the first Sunday after Christ had been crucified and laid to rest in his tomb. The first rays of sunlight spilled over the horizon like light through a stained glass window.
A group of women who loved Christ in life walked silently in the shadows to anoint his body with spices for burial. There had not been time for this before he was placed in the tomb. Arriving at the tomb, they found the stone had been rolled away. They went in only to find that the tomb was empty.
Suddenly, two men in dazzling clothes appeared beside them, making amazing claims, the kinds of claims that you just cannot believe. Later that day, two of the apostles were going to take a journey from Jerusalem to a place called Emmaus.
Hey, where are you going?
Why don't you stay with us? Come on, we insist. Have dinner with us.
This is my body, broken for you.
Jesus!
Jesus!
He's gone!
But our hope has returned! Jesus is alive! Even death can't hold him! We've got to tell the others! They're not crazy yet!
Come on, let's go!
There is no escape from God who never abandons us. Jesus meets us wherever we are. Even death did not separate Jesus from his followers.
But were they really followers?
The disciples on the road to Emmaus had given up. They said, "We had hoped that he was the one to redeem Israel." They were walking away, thinking that the empty tomb was the end of the story. They were leaving behind the hope that they had in going to Jerusalem. Perhaps they were escaping too, and feared that as followers of Jesus, they might face the same torture and death.
And Jesus' followers were not, but now we're walking away in another direction. If we give up hope, lose hope, or are afraid, Jesus does not leave us behind, but meets us wherever we are. Where we are going, Jesus comes to meet us, or even especially on our path of desperation, abandonment, and escape.
The Bible stories of Jesus' resurrection remind us to be alert for Jesus' presence. We may meet Jesus when we least expect it. We may meet Jesus in someone who does not know about Jesus. When we ourselves are discouraged, Jesus may come to us in strangers who call forth from us the stories of our faith.
When we show hospitality to strangers, Jesus is present.
Jesus is present when we share food with strangers or with other believers.
Jesus is present when we gather to tell of our experiences of Jesus.
Jesus is present to us when we're disbelieving.
Jesus is beside us when we are grieving Jesus' absence in our lives.
Jesus stands among us when we fear persecution because of being Jesus' followers.
Jesus comes to us when we doubt.
Jesus is with us as we go about our daily occupations, and Jesus promised to meet us in the midst of our daily lives.
This is the good news.